input-output stream in Java. Now, first is what are streams? Now, stream, it is an object that either delivers data to its destination or that takes data from a source. Now, the destination can be a screen or a file, and the source can be a keyboard or a file. So, you can take the data from a keyboard or file, and you can send the data to the monitor or the file. Now, what is the input stream? It is a stream that provides input to a program. For example, we have already used system.in. It is an input stream. Output stream is the stream that accepts output from a program, and we have already used system.out as a output stream. Now, a stream connects a program to an input-output object. So, system.out connects a program to the screen, and system.in connects a program to the keyboard. Now, a stream is an abstraction of continuous one-way flow of data. For example, this is a program and we want to read from a file. So the input stream is required, and when we want to show some output, then output stream is required. For example, we want to read from a file that is on the hard disk, and we want to write on that file also. So to read from a file, we need input stream. So the data will come from file, and this program will read that data. And this program wants to write some data into this file, then in that case, output stream is required. Now, streams are a clean way to deal with input-output without changing any code for different devices. Now, there are two types of streams, for, byte streams and character streams. Now, what are byte streams? They provide a convenient means for handling input-output of bytes. They are used for reading and writing binary data. So, the streams that are dealing with the 0 and 1s is known as byte stream. Now, what is a character stream? It provides a convenient way for handling input-output of characters. They use Unicode. So, in case of Java, we use Unicode characters. Now, byte stream, the examples of byte streams are input stream and output stream classes. They are already defined. Input stream is used for reading the data, and output stream is used for displaying the data. Now, the character streams, for character streams, we have reader class for reading the data and writer class for writing the data to the screen. So, these are the character streams. Now, the subclasses of input stream and output streams are analogs to the subclasses of reader and writer. Now, this is the hierarchy of byte stream classes. As you can say, object class is the super class of all the classes. That is the default super class of all the classes that have already been defined in Java and that we create. So, then we have input stream, output stream. So, in case of input stream, we have these subclasses, and in case of output stream, we have these classes. So, this is the hierarchy of byte stream classes. This is the hierarchy of character stream classes. Object class is the super class of all these classes. Reader is the subclass of object class that is used for reading the data, and these are the subclasses of reader. That means these classes are inheriting reader class and indirectly inheriting the object class. Now, writer class is used for displaying the character data. So, these are the subclasses of writer class. So, they are inheriting the properties of writer class, and indirectly they are inheriting the properties of object class. Now, console input and output using byte stream. As we have already done the programming in Java, the simple programs have been created, and in that case we were using to take the data from the user, we use system.in, that is, and for displaying the data we have already used system.out. Now, the Java programs automatically import java.lang package, and it includes system class. So, there is no need to import the java.lang package, because that is the default package that is automatically imported. Now, the system class contains predefined stream variables, in and out. System.in is an object of input stream, and system.out is an object of output stream. Now, these are byte stream, but typically used to read and write characters from and to the console. The example of the output to the console is, when we want to display a message on the screen, we use system.out.lang. Now reading from the console input device. Now scanner is a class that is used to take input from the console. The constructor of this class takes an object of type java.ir.input stream that stores information about the connection between the input device and the computer of the program. So to take the data from the user, we need a class, scanner class. So in the scanner class constructor, we have to pass system.in. System.in is used to make a connection between the input device and the computer program. And in the scanner class, we have some methods like nextInt, that is for taking reading the integer value. Next float for taking the reading the float value. Next will read a character, and next line method will read a string. Now reading console input using character string. So use the character string to make the program easier to maintain and internationalize. Now input stream reader is class is used to obtain character based string, and system.in is used for reading from console. Now we have to create an instance of input stream reader class, and in the constructor we have to pass system.in, because that is the object that is used to connect to the input device. Now buffer reader is the class that supports buffer read input stream, and in that we have to pass the instance of input stream reader. Now this buffer reader class is used for reading a character. So read is the method, and it throws IO exception, that is input output exception. Now next method is that we use is readline. It also throws IO exception. Now it is used for reading a string from the console. Writing console output using character string. Now printer writer is the class, or you can say the stream, that is used for writing to the console in the real world problems. Buffers are automatically flushed when the program acts normally. Usually it is your responsibility to flush buffers if the program does not end normally. Now the print writer class can do the flushing for automatically, and this is the constructor of print writer class, and in that we have to pass the object of output stream and the boolean value, that is for the auto flush. Now its object supports the print and println methods for all types including object. Now how to process the external files. Processing of external files means that we want to read some data from the files that are existing on the disk, or we want to write some data onto the files that are available on the hard disk. Now for this you must use the file streams to read from or write to a disk file. So in this case, when we are using files for reading and writing the data, we need file streams for this these operations. Now the byte streams used for reading from and writing to the files are file input stream, that is used for reading, and file output stream, that is used for writing into a file. Now the character stream that we use for reading and writing are file reader. Now file reader is a stream, that the character stream that we use for reading from a file, and file writer is a class that we use for writing into a file. Now what are the advantages of file input output? There are several advantages. First advantage is there is a permanent copy. Suppose you are writing some data on the disk on a file, then that will become the permanent copy, and that can be referred after months. So output from one program can be input to another. Now suppose two files are there, file 1 and file 2. Now we are reading the data from file 1 and we are writing that data into the file 2. So that is possible. Now input can be automated rather than entered manually. So when we are reading the data from one file and we are writing that data into another file, then that becomes automatic. In that case, we are not taking the data from the user. Now there are two types of files, binary files and text files. Now all data and programs are ultimately just zeros and ones. Now each digit can have one of the two values, that is either 0 or 1, that is the binary data. Now bit is a binary digit and byte is a group of 8 bits. Now text file, the bits represent printable characters. So 1 byte per character for ASCII and they are not printable files. Actually, you can print them, but they will not be, they will be unintelligible. Printable means easily readable by human when printed. So there is a difference between the text files and the binary files. Now the text files are more readable by humans. Binary files are more efficient, as computers read and write binary files more easily than text, because that is the language of the computer that is understood by it. Now Java binary files are portable. They can be used by Java on different machines. Reading and writing binary files is normally done by a program, and the text files are used only to communicate with humans. Now there is a difference between Java text files and Java binary files. Java text files are the source file in which the program is written, and Java binary files are the executable files. For example, when we are writing a program, we are creating a .java file. So that is a Java text file, and when we compile that file, it will become executable file, and we have the dot class file. So that comes under Java binary files. Now we occasionally input these types of files, but we usually use input files. Java binary files are input files, and we occasionally use Java text files for the output files, but we usually do the processing with the binary files. Now for example, suppose we have a number 127. Now in a text file, it will be represented as 3 bytes, 1, 2 and 7. And the ASCII code for this 127 is 49, 50 and 55. And in octal, it is 61, 62 and 67. And in binary, this is the code. But in case of binary file, the 127 will be stored. In case of 1 byte, it will be stored like this. In case of 2 bytes, it will be stored like this, and in case of 4 bytes, it will be take it as int and it will be stored in 4 bytes. So this, there is a difference in storing the data. Now text file input output. Now the important classes for text file output are print writer and file output stream, or you can say the file writer class. So important classes for text file input are buffer reader and file reader. So file output stream and file reader takes the file names as arguments, and print writer and buffer reader provides useful methods for easier writing and reading. Usually need a combination of two classes, because you want to read and write the data into a file. Now to use these classes, we have to import the package, that is java.io package, that is the input output package, that is the statement that is required in the program. Now every file has two names. Two names means the stream name used by Java, that is the output stream in the example, and the name used by the operating system, that is the text file that in which we want to store or from which we want to read the data. Now text file output. To open a text file for output, now we have to connect a text file to a stream for writing. So for that writing, we need the print writer class instance. And in that, we are passing the instance of file output stream. And in file output stream, we are passing the name of the file with extension. So in this case, it is a text file. That's why it is written out.txt. Out is the name of the file, and txt is the extension. That is for the text file. Now, this is a one-step process. Now, we can write two statements, because here we are passing the instance of file output stream. So instead of directly passing the instance, we can first create the instance of file output stream like this. S is the instance of file output stream, and then we are passing the name of the file in, from which we want to read, and then we have created the print writer instance, and in that we are passing the constructor, the instance of file output stream. Now what is the goal? The goal is to create a print writer object which uses file output stream to open a text file with the name out.txt. Now the output file stream. So what we are doing, we are actually passing print writer, and in print writer we are passing the file output stream, and then it will read the data from the file on that is on the disk. So print writer, this is the instance of the print writer. In the constructor of the print writer, we are passing the the instance of file output stream. Now the methods for print writer are, so it is different, it is similar to the methods of system.out.println. So what we have to do, we have to use the instance of print writer dot name of the method is println, and then we can display. So print, format, flush and close, these are the methods that are defined in print writer class. Now you can see here, this is the text file output demo. Now in this particular case, we have created an instance. We have not created an instance, but we have declared a variable output stream of type print writer, and we have passed null. Now this, when we are creating an instance of print writer, we have kept this in the try block, because output stream would not be accessible to the rest of the method if it were declared inside the try block. So we have declared the variable outside, but we have created the instance inside the try block, because it will generate an exception. It can generate an exception, whether if the file does not exist, then it will, it can generate the exception, file not found exception. So and file output stream, we are passing the name of the file, and this is used for if this file out.txt is not available, then it will automatically create this file on the disk. And this is here we are catching that exception, that is the file not found exception. Now text file output demo. Now we are asking for the three lines of text, and then how to read the data. We are reading the data keyboard dot next line, and then we are displaying this with the output stream dot println. Now every file, this is called the writing to the file. We are writing to the out dot txt file. Now every time when we are opening a stream, we have to close. When we are opening a file for reading or writing, we have to close that file, and for that we will use the instance of file writer and then the close method. Now how to overwrite a file. Now opening an output file creates an empty file. See, if the file does not exist on the disk, then that is automatically created. So it will be created an empty file. Opening an output file creates a new file if it does not already exist. Now opening an output file that already exists eliminates old file and creates a new empty one. Now data in the original file is lost. So see, if your file already exists and if you are reading the data from the file, then it is fine. But if you have opened the file in by using the file output stream, in that case, the when you are writing that data onto the file, the previous data will be lost. So how to append to a text file. Now we have to add or append to the text file so that the previous data will not be lost. So in the file output stream class, we have to pass a boolean value, that is true. Now second parameter, append to the end of the file if it exists. See, if the file exists, then it will move this true value will define that the cursor will move to the end of the file, and the data that we are writing, that will be written at the end of the file. So that data will be appended with the previous one. So this is a sample code for telling the user how to replace or append. So for example, in this case, we are taking the data from the user, and then this is the append value. If answer is A, then it will return true. Small A or capital A, it will return true. And then we are passing this value to the file output stream. Now how to close a file. Now an output file should be closed when you are done writing to it, and use the close method of the class print writer. And buffer reader, we are also having a close method. For example, to close the file opened in the previous example, we have to write the instance of the print writer dot the close method. Now if our program ends normally, it will close all the files that are open. But when the program ends abnormally, then in that case there can be a problem. So why to bother to close the file? Now the question is, why it is necessary to use the close method for all the files? Now if a program automatically closes files, then it ends normally. Why close them with the explicit call to close? So that is the question. Now there are two reasons why to use this close method. To make sure it is closed if a program ends abnormally. So sometimes it may happen that your program terminates abnormally or some exception has been generated. In that case, it could be a damage to the file that is open. So that is the reason, that is the first reason that we have to use the close method. Second thing is, a file opened for writing must be closed before it can be opened for reading. So although Java does have a class that opens the file for both reading and writing, it is not used in this text. Now text file input. To open a text file for input, connect a text file to a stream for reading, and buffer reader is the class that, and the file reader is the class for opening a file in a read mode. So file reader connects buffer reader to the text file. For example, this is the code that we have to write. We have to create an instance of buffer reader, and in the constructor buffer reader we have to pass the instance of file reader, and in the file reader constructor we have to specify the name in a string with extension. So we can write it in two steps also. First we will create an instance of file reader, and in file reader we are specifying the name of the file, and then we are passing this file reader instance in buffer reader constructor, and we are creating an instance of buffer reader class. So this is the case. We want to read some data from the disk. So to connect to the disk, we need the file reader, and file reader instance will be passed to the buffer reader so that it can be connected to the program. So this is the case when we can read the data from the file. Now methods for buffer reader class. Readline is the method that is used for reading the string, and no method to read numbers directly. So read numbers as strings and then convert them. So everything that we will read through buffer reader, that it will read it as a string, and then we have to convert. For example, if we are to convert that string into integer, then parseInt is the method that we can use. Now read method is used for reading a character at a time, and close method is used for closing the string. Now exception handling with file input output. The exception generated by during the input output handling of a file is IO exception. That is the input output exception. That is a predefined class, and we throw file input output throw this exception. So catch the exception in a catch block that at least prints an error message and ends the program. Now another type of exception that can occur is file not found exception. This type of exception occurs when we want to open a file for reading that does not exist. So in that case, this exception will be generated. So therefore we have to catch this exception when we are opening a file for reading. Now put the more specific one first, so it catches specifically file not found exception, and then you will know that an input output error is something other than file not found. Now this is an example of reading a file name from a keyboard. So this is the case. We have taken a string file name and we have passed null. Then we have created an instance of scanner class, that is the keyboard, and then we are reading the data, that is the name of the file, from the keyboard, and then we are passing this name to the file reader constructor that is connecting to the file, and then this instance of file reader is passed to the buffer reader class. So input stream is used for reading the text, and then we are displaying that text. Now in this case we have closed this file that we have opened. So reading a file name from the keyboard, we use scanner class, and using the file name read from the keyboard, we have used this here. We have passed it into the file reader class. Now then we are reading the data from the file. So first we have caught the file not found exception, because in this case we want to read some data from a file. So first we have to check whether that file exists or not. If that file does not exist, in that case that exception will be caught in file not found exception, this cache block. If that file exists but there is a exception generated is input output exception, then that exception will be caught in this block. And we can generate a message by using the file not found exception instance e dot get message, so it will generate an exception. Now testing for end of file in a text file. So if you want to, if you are reading the data from the file and we want to find out whether the end of file has reached or not, then in that case read line tries to read beyond the end of the text file, it returns a special value null. If the read line method returns null, that means that is the end of file and it will stop processing a text file. Now if read method returns minus 1 when it tries to read beyond the end of a text file. Now the int value of all ordinary characters is non-negative, so it will return minus 1, that means this is the end of file. Neither of these two methods will throw an end of file exception. So read and read line methods will not generate any type of exception, end of file exception. Now this is an example using null to test for end of file in a text file. For example, in this case we already created the instance of FileReader class, so we are using the readLine method and then we are checking whether line is not equal to null, then we have to increment the count and then it is checking for the null. So if it will be null, then it will come out of the loop. Now the file class. File is an inbuilt class. It acts like a wrapper class for file names. A file name can like numbers.txt has only string properties. Now there are some useful methods of the file class. First method is exist. Now it this method returns a boolean value and it will tell if the file already exists or not. Then can read. Now it will test if the operating system will let you read a file or not. Can write. It will test if the operating system will let you write to a file or not. Delete. Deletes it method. This method deletes the file. Returns true if successful. Then the length method is there. It will return the number of bytes in the file. Get name is used for finding the. It will return the file name excluding the preceding path. Now get path returns the path name, that is the full name. So how to use this? We have to create an instance of file class and then in the file constructor we have to pass the name of the file. So we can test whether this file exists or not. It will return true if that does not exist, and this method is displaying the length of number of bytes that are already written in that particular file. Now file objects and file names. So file input stream and output stream have constructor that take a file argument as well as constructor that takes a string argument. For example, in this case print writer, we have already done this print writer instance, we have created an instance of print writer, and in the constructor we are passing an instance of file output stream. So now in the next statement we have used the file class and we have created an instance of file class and we have passed the name of the file in the constructor. Now we are checking, can we write in this file or not? Right, for writing we will use the printWriter class. Now this is an alternative method for reading. Now instead of buffer reader with file reader, we can use the scanner with the file. So scanner in file, new scanner class, and then we are passing the name of the file. So it is similar to system.in. So how to read the integer values from a file by using next int. So has int method returns true if the file consists of integer values. Now how to read the number of lines. So for that next line is the method, and has next line method will return whether the file contains the characters or not. If it contains the characters, then this value will work, otherwise it will not work. Now multiple types on one line. So scanner we have created a file. We have created an instance of scanner and then we have passed the instance of file, and in.txt is the file from where we want to read the data. First we are checking whether it has next, it has character or not. If it has character, then we have to read that character, and then we are reading the integer, and then we are reading a float value. Now again string, we have taken a variable line that is of type string. Then we are checking that it has number of strings in that, has next line. If it has strings, then we are reading the string value, and then we have again used the scanner class and we are passing this line. Now we are reading the next character, and in that we are reading the next integer value. This is where we are reading the next float value. Similar is the case for this multiple types on one line. We have created an instance of scanner class, and we want to read from the in.txt file. So we are checking whether there is a number of strings in that file or not. If that number of strings are there, then we have to read those strings, and then we are passing that string to the account class. So in account class, account method, we are this is the account constructor in which we are passing the string that we have read from the file, and then we are reading the data. So this was all about the input output streams and file handling.